I belonged to a family where there was a patient with terminal disease like pancreatic cancer, having no cure. I personally gone through the agony and the mental trauma along with the patient. When the patient is waiting for the ultimate death, where there is no medication or no cure is being provided. It is different than other kind of cancer where there is a treatment, when the patient has hope to at least recover or get better because there is a treatment going on. But in cases like pancreatic cancer where there is no treatment available, it's really a traumatic experience for the patient as well as the member of the family, because they feel helpless, they feel hopeless, and they really don't know what to do to change the situation. They can't change. Now, we wanted to make a film which give some kind of a direction or plan of action when such situation exists, both for the patient and for the members of their family. We know that you cannot delay their departure or death, or you cannot do anything to make them medically fit or recover, but you can still do a lot of things. For instance, you can make the patient feel special, you can make them feel important, you can make them feel loved, you can make them feel being cared, you can make them feel how much you are going to miss, and you can make their stay, as long as they are not dead, a very, very memorable life experience. The whole idea of making this film came from my personal experience when my mother was suffering from cancer, and she got cured in the first time, and when there was a relapse and the doctor said that now there is no chance of her survival. And any curative medication will only, or trying to increase her lifespan will only increase her miseries and her suffering. And therefore, Dr. Chandi of Tata Medical Hospital told me that if she was my mother, I would have let her go. And he said, I will only suggest palliative care, which will reduce her pain, but I would not suggest any curative medication because that's not going to help and that's going to only increase her pain and suffering. And therefore, if her breathing stops, I am not going to put her on a ventilator. And if her heart stops, I am not going to give her any electric shock. And no medication will be given for any extension. Although there was a medication, there was injections which was costing some 25 lakhs per injection. And he said, it may just work, but the chances of success is only 15%. And even after it succeeds, she will suffer. So we ultimately gave up. What we did instead was that we gave her our time. We gave all the love we could shower on her. We could make many of her desires come true. We made sure that she eats every day her favorite food. We made sure that she watches the films she would like to watch, which were her favorite films. We also wanted to read out certain books she wanted to read, but she was not able to read, and so on and so forth. Many things we did which made her life much better while she was still alive. So I got this inspiration from this experience, and therefore I made this film. Our film is about a girl having a pancreatic cancer, and since she is not having any cure and she doesn't want to stay in a place where everybody is asking about her health, she is advised by her doctor to go to a very scenic place like Darjeeling and spend her remaining time there among the beauty of the mountain and the clouds and so on, where she comes and she is very happy. She starts working for a tea company. And ultimately, there's a boy who falls in love with her. When the boy declares her love, she goes in a withdrawal symptoms, which is a normal reaction of a pancreatic cancer who goes through different kind of psychiatric problem also, and many of them go through depression. Now the boy doesn't know that she is suffering from pancreatic cancer, and therefore she is unable to find out why the behavior of the girl has suddenly changed. So ultimately he goes and asks the girl in a very desperate manner that why is she behaving like that, and she faints. Now then, when she is admitted in a hospital for recovery, he comes to know from her father that she is suffering from pancreatic cancer and she has at the most 6 months time left. The boy goes under the instruction of the father to bring the medical file of the girl to the hospital, and while on the way, being disturbed mentally, meets an accident, and he comes in the same hospital. Then the boy tells the girl, once he recovers, because he's not injured more, that he could have gone before her, and she is thinking that she will go on a certain date, and if she make the relationship more intense, the boy will suffer. He said, I will suffer anyway, even if you leave me now. But see, instead of feeling miserable waiting for the death, why don't we make most out of the life which is left with us and celebrate it? And he picks up a book where it is written things to do before you die, and they start celebrating life, and they had a great time celebrating life. They do things which will bring to reality fantasies which the girl had from childhood, which was amazing fantasies, not very easily achievable, but they make it possible. So whatever time the girl had, they had a great time. They made that her living a very, very memorable experience. And this is the message we want to give it to the patient as well as the member of their family, that though we can't avoid the unavoidable death, but we can definitely make their living or their lives left to live a very memorable experience, so that the person who's leaving will have a great satisfaction of having lived a very eventful, very memorable and very exciting life. And the person who are left, the family member or the loved ones, they'll have a feeling that they could do everything which was in their hand to make the departed soul's life worth living or memorable. So it's beneficial to both of them. Now, we would like the cancer societies or the cancer support groups to screen this film on 4th of February, which is the World Cancer Day. And I am sure that this will give some direction and plan of action to these patients as well as their family member, to act positively instead of feeling miserable, to make most of whatever life is left, which is a positive thing to do. So I would request all the cancer society and the cancer support group to come forward. We'll help them to get probably a free theater to screen the film, and we'll also give them the film for free. So this can be part of the activity which they normally do on a World Cancer Day, which is on 4th of February. So if you are really interested as a cancer society or cancer support group, please get in touch with us. We'll help you to be able to organize this in the forthcoming 4th February 2022. And I think this is going to make a great contribution in the life of these patients as well as their member of family. Thank you.